Time now to check in with Richard Souther now at 680 News. And Richard, we're hearing some more about Canada's top CEOs and what they'll be making this year. And they'll be making as much today as a lot of us do over the course of all of 2017, which is nice, right?
Can you believe that? Yeah. It's further signs we're in the wrong business. We should be in the C-suite, the corporate suite, as they call it, Tammy. We should be calling the shots, making the big money, because, yeah, indeed, Canadian CEOs are pulling it in. And as you say, this new report out this morning from the Center for Policy Alternatives finds that the average Canadian CEO will earn as much as the average full-time Canadian worker by 11:47 a.m. this morning. The average CEO making about $9.5 million, some 193 times the average wage of Canadians. And the Center for Policy Alternatives says this is an issue because of the way CEOs earn their salary through stock grants and stock options. It says that can lead them to make decisions that benefit themselves rather than the company or the public at whole in the long term. It suggests Ottawa should level the playing field by getting rid of tax breaks for stock options. So there you go. CEO is going to make as much as you do by before noon today. Next, interesting news about Bitcoin. Remember Bitcoin, the digital currency? Not only is it still around, but it has gone way up. The cryptocurrency was one of the best performing investments of 2016, and this morning it has cracked the $1,000 US mark for the first time since 2013. Bitcoin's actually doubled in value last year. It takes a $1,358 to buy a single Bitcoin. The currency is used to move money around the globe quickly and anonymously. It's free of control from any central bank or government. And so that makes it attractive to those who want to get around capital controls. It's done especially well since the election of Donald Trump. So Bitcoin red hot. And stocks are red hot. We're getting set to kick off 2017 on the markets. 2016 was good to Bay Street. The Toronto stock market was the best performing stock market in the world last year, up 18%. So we'll look for a continuation of that. U.S. futures are way up this morning. Dow futures gaining 125 points. It's thanks to some solid manufacturing news coming out of China. We take a look at the price of oil. It is just shy of $55 per barrel. That's about an 18-month high. So that's good news for Bay Street. Bad news when it comes to the gas pumps. Of course, we're paying about 12 cents a liter more than we were before Christmas, what with the cap and trade fees in Ontario. But that price of oil you're looking at could continue to push the price of gas up through the balance of the week. Gold down $4.20. It's been selling off lately. And the Canadian dollar trading this morning at 74.49 cents U.S. Tammy, back over to you.